Hill Development Corporation, Senior Executive, sir.
Sir, who is taking the program ahead?
Sir, hello.
Who's leading the program?
Yes, sir. Mr. Prashant from ADP project, sir. I am under, sir.
We start the program 12:30, no?
Yes, sir. Sir, interactive one, sir. Hello, sir. Subram Reddy garu. Hello, Subram Reddy garu, sir. Hello.
Hello. Doping is. అంటే Hello. Hello. వస్తుందా? నేను మాట్లాడచ్చా? ఓకే, థ్యాంక్ యూ. మనకి కనపడదు. సరే సార్. హలో, గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్. హలో, డాక్టర్ ఆర్జే శ్రీకాంత్ గారు అండ్ అదర్ కొలీగ్స్ అండ్ పార్టిసిపెంట్స్, ఐఎమ్ డాక్టర్ సుబ్రహ్మ రెడ్డి, ప్రిన్సిపల్ సైంటిస్ట్ సీడ్స్ ఎట్ యాంగ్రూ హెడ్ క్వార్టర్స్ లామ్ గుంటూర్. టుడే ఐఎమ్ ప్రజెంటింగ్ ది ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ బయో ఫర్టిలైజర్స్ అండ్ బయో పెస్టిసైడ్స్ అండ్ ఇట్స్ దేర్ ప్రాక్టికల్ యూటిలిటీ ఇన్ సస్టైనబుల్ అగ్రికల్చర్. why this we have talking about biofertilizers and biopesticides is there is a decline in crop productivity in India since 1997-98. There is a strong correlation in between fertilizer consumption and food grain production. After that, there is a distorted relationship in these two, fertilizer and food grain production. Most of these states are experiencing increase in fertilizer consumption with a slower pace of crop productivity. Some states witnessed the consumption of fertilizer picking up without any conspicuous gain on agriculture crop productivity. The main reasons are imbalanced and indiscriminate use of chemical fertilizers, continuous fragmentation of land unfavorable for adaptation of technology, and land holding pattern and predominance of marginal and small farmers. And then deterioration of it, which resulted in deterioration of soil health. If you take the current scenario of Indian agriculture and the promotion of biofertilizers and pesticides, there is a lot of scope for biofertilizers and biopesticides consumption and usage and distribution also. There is no doubt that the Green Revolution brought impressive gains in food production, but with sufficient concern for sustainability. In India, the availability and affordability of fossil fuel-based chemical fertilizers at the farm level have been ensured only through imports and subsidies. Dependence on chemical fertilizers for future agriculture growth would mean further loss in soil quality and the possibility of water contamination. The government of India has been trying to promote an improved practice involving use of biofertilizers along with fertilizers. And if you take Andhra Pradesh as example, it is a very good sign and good step towards promoting biofertilizers and biopesticides by state skill development corporation. It is an initiative which is highly welcomeable. There is a lot of scope for use of biofertilizers and biopesticides in Andhra Pradesh, particularly to get the sustainable agriculture. These are the constraints for biotechnology development and assimilation in developing countries, especially financial, technical capability, infrastructure, lack of infrastructure, ambivalent policies, trade issues, biosafety regulations, and intellectual property protection, public perception. So many things are there are a lot of problems are there. Even then, there are we can go through biotechnologies, traditional biotechnologies for rural India way forward, compiling data on application of major traditional biotechnologies. We can fill up the gap analysis, capacity building, training of trainers, innovative extension mechanism, developing marketing linkages. These things we can consider. If you come into the why biofertilizers, biofertilizer is not a fertilizer. It adds nutrients through the natural process of nitrogen fixation and then solubilizing phosphorus, stimulating plant growth through the synthesis of growth promoting substances, helps in growing healthy plants while enhancing the sustainability and the health of the soil. If you take biofertilizers into different parts, nitrogen fixing biofertilizers, these are three types: symbiotic group, that is rhizobium active in legumes, Ezella anabena. They both are a symbiotic group, and it comes under associative endophytic group or Azospirillum, particularly non symbiotic groups, Agitobacter, BGA, Bacillus, other will come. If you take the importance of leguminous crops under nitrogen fixing, the value of nitrogen fixing legumes is important in improving and sustaining soil fertility. Integrating of pulse crops in farming system as grain pulses, green manure crops, forages, intercrops, vegetable pulses and like fences are most successful examples of biological nitrogen fixation. Rhizobium and its cross inoculating groups are major important biofertilizers in legumes. If you see the difference, uninoculated and inoculated with rhizobium, this is the impact of biofertilizers in any pulse crop. If you take the nitrogen fixing capacity in pulses, rhizobium will fix around 21 to 140 kg per hectare nitrogen in black gram, whereas 9 to 112 kg in green gram, 7 to 235 kg per hectare in pigeon pea, and 9 to 201 kgs per hectare in cowpea, and 3 to 141 kgs per hectare in chickpea gram. This indicates that we can 100% reduce the nitrogen fertilizers by 25 to 30% in any crop, especially pulses and other cereal crops also. For effective nodulation, generally competitive efficiently nodulating nitrogen fixing strains of rhizobia and their inoculation can solve many problems. And then rhizobium inoculation of pulses increase yields by, in pulses it increases by 15 to 30%. That means around 0.5 to 2 quintals per hectare in most of the cases we can increase the yield with this utilization of rhizobium, which costs only 10 to 15 rupees per acre. That means around 50 rupees per hectare. It increases the yield by 2 quintals per hectare minimum, and then in most in some cases it is even go up to 3 quintals per hectare. In other if you take other nitrogen fixing bacteria, Azoosporillum for non-legume crops, this can also can be used in paddy, sugarcane, cotton and chilies. And Azoosporillum fixes around 10 to 30 kg nitrogen per hectare in paddy and 10 to 20 kg per hectare in other crops per season. It is not a host specific, but a preference will be with the C4 plants. Wide number of host crops can be inoculated with Azoosporillum. And experimental results indicates that it will increase the yield up to 20% in different crops, especially wheat, rice, maize, barley, and a minimum of 13 to 15% yield advantage we can get it through Azoosporillum. Because of this, we can reduce the nitrogen. And in addition to this Azoosporillum, it enhances the nitrogen fixation. Along with that, it produces phytohormones in the crop roots. But ideal conditions to obtain good result for with Azoosporillum are there should not be high ammonical nitrogen content in the soil, should not create much anaerobic conditions in the field. Application of FIM along with Azoosporillum improves the response of Azoosporillum in crop production. To have good response from Azoosporillum, we need at least apply 10 to the power of 7 cells per seedling. 75% of the experiments trials had given positive results with Azoosporillum in Angro and throughout the India also. Nitrogen fixing bacteria, one more important nitrogen fixing bacteria is Agitobacter, a symbiotic nitrogen fixer. It is a free living or associative nitrogen fixer. It prefers more organic carbon for effective nitrogen fixation. It is widely used for vegetables and flower gardens. It can produce plant hormones and vitamins. It can tolerate to temperature stress. This is the Agitobacter developed at isolated at ARS Amravati. It is being supplied to the farmers in large quantities. Generally, we are recommending 2 kgs of Agitobacter plus along with 200 kgs of organic manure per acre. This Agitobacter influences, we can see in all crops, it ranges from 2 to 24% in different crops. For effective inoculation, also identification of same competitive and efficient nitrogen strain we have to identify. It can solve so many problems, and inoculation in vegetables increases yields by 10 to 12%. This increase may be seen in quality and taste also. Other biofertilizers, especially nitrogen fixing biofertilizers, are mostly used in rice, which are useful for rice are blue green algae and azolla. These are also picking up in Andhra Pradesh and other states also. Ejella, if you applied, it is very good for paddy crop. Ejella contributes around 40 to 60 kg nitrogen per hectare. It doubles in 2 to 3 days. And inoculum production 8 kg per 1 cent. Application of GA3 induces a sporulation in Ejella. Dose around 200 kg fresh per hectare after 7 to 10 days after transplantation. It is also, this technology is also picking up in Andhra Pradesh. And next important biofertilizer is phosphorus solubilizing microorganism PSB. And phosphorus is present in soils both in organic and inorganic forms. Organic materials including decayed plant, animal and microbial tissues is an important reservoir of immobilized P, accounting for about 20 to 80% of total soil P. Plants take P in the form of H2PO4 and HPO4, mostly in H2PO4 form. Most of the orthophosphate reacts in soil and gets fixed. Particular attention is paid to identifying such microbes and the mechanisms by which they solubilize insoluble P and promote the growth of plants. This PSP stimulates the plant growth by providing hormones and vitamins and other growth factors. This is the mechanism of P solubilization by PSP. So many activities are there: acid phosphatase, phytolysis, organic acids production and inorganic acids production, release of H+ release accompanying NH4. These are the phosphorus solubilizing bacteria and fungal cultures, especially Pseudomonas, Bacillus, Aspergillus and Serratia. These are being commercially multiplied and distributing to the farmers in Andhra Pradesh. And the most of the farmers who are well known with biofertilizers, they are using these PSB. And this is, we can say, this phosphatase solubilizing bacteria produces indolacetic acid, ACC deaminase, cytokinesis and gibberellins, which can increase the root proliferation and in turn it enhances the nutrient uptake. In the other parts, it produces antibiotics and cytochrome and HCN, it produces HCN also, and these are useful for control of some soil-borne diseases also. This application of phosphorus mobilizing bacteria or phosphorus solubilizing bacteria, application must be done along with organic manure, which is essential for production of organic acids. Phosphate solubilizing microbes cohabit in the rhizosphere with other agronomically beneficial microbes. The amount of P2O5 release will be around 20 to 24 kg per hectare, P2O5 per hectare during the crop season. Subsequently, dramatic increase in yield of various crops following the soil inoculation with phosphorus solubilizing organisms and other plant growth promoting rhizobacteria. The protection of the soil environment by applying phosphorus solubilizing and mobilizing bacteria could become a major breakthrough for plants grown in derelict soils. And one more important phosphorus solubilizing bacteria is orbicular mycorrhizal fungi. The threads that bind soil particles and plant roots, they are symbiotic with the plants. They transport P and other nutrients from the deeper layers of soils and deposit in plant roots. They protect crop from water stress. They protect crop from root pathogens. In intercropping, they form a network to exchange nutrients between the two crops. This is the mycorrhizal biofertilizer production at ARS Amaravati, and the five phases we are producing this VAM, and the effect of VAM on different crops was studied at ARS Amaravati and by Yangru. In soybean, the percentage increase is around 19%. Whereas in chickpea it is 25%, in chilies it is 55%, and in groundnut it is 10 to 20%, in finger millet it is 18%. So it is very effective in increasing the yield, as well as it controls soil borne diseases excellently. Along with this, at ARS Amaravati, our scientists isolated potassium releasing bacteria and this bacteria is also 2 kg per acre we are recommending. And with this, we can supply at least 25% of the potassium requirement, 12 to 15 kg per hectare. It improves the lateral roots formation, improves grain weight and quality, and improves oil content in oil seed crops, improves disease resistance mechanism in crop plants. And then, at ARS Amravati and other centers, where plant growth promoting rhizobacteria is also plays a major role, and the PGPR, we are calling it, this PGPR can against soil borne diseases we are trying. Field level, with my practical experience with this, all these bio, in combination use of this biofertilizers, azospirillum or on the PSB and KRB, and that is potash releasing bacteria, 2 kgs each with orbicular mycorrhiza, 5 kg per hectare in chilies. It had given excellent result at farmer fields, and we can save at least 1500 rupees per acre with this biofertilizers. And the cost per acre is also just 410 rupees per acre, where with that we can reduce the at least 1 bag per acre in chili crop, and it had been successful, and farmers are fully satisfied, and around 10,000 to 15,000 acres is last year we supplied to the farmers, and it is being encouraged by the Department of Horticulture, Department of Agriculture and other agencies also. It is picking up very well in Andhra Pradesh. And there are some field level constraints also there, soil and climatic factors, native, that means moisture and other factors, native microbial population also influences the effectiveness, and then faulty inoculation technique. Some people they apply with chemical fertilizers which kills these microbes, and the crop management techniques also plays major role in utilizing of this biofertilizers, and then quality control is also major factor with regard to constraint. And there are different formulations of biofertilizer, alginate weights, clay hulls, dry powders, liquid inoculates, and biofilms in different mixed formulations. Combination of PGPR, azospirillum, PSV and PGPRs, we are at different lines, and it is a, we can say, major breakthrough in biofertilizer production in Andhra Pradesh especially, and at ARS Amravati, liquid biofertilizers had been developed, and these are being supplied to the farmers with different agencies, Agriculture Department, Horticulture Department, NGOs, and other agencies also. This is advantage of this liquid bioinoculants are it is mostly it is free from contaminants, protection from seed exudates, more shelf life. Generally, powder form biofertilizers had like shelf life of 6 months, whereas liquid biofertilizers we can the shelf life is 12 to 18 months. So we can have better chance of utilizing in the other next season also, and then high population and temperature tolerant, and there is they can tolerate the higher temperatures also in liquid form, and the population is also very high, and the quick and easy testing of quality of biofertilizers is also possible with the liquid inoculants, and easy to apply. And easy to apply means we can apply through drip irrigation also, irrigation, drip irrigation tanks also, we can apply this liquid biofertilizers. The methods are different methods we are adapting: direct application, liquid inoculation, dusting, slurry inoculation by seed coating, seed pelleting, and solid inoculation. These methods we are used for biofertilizer application. And most important thing is we should take precautions while applying biofertilizers, especially uniform coating should be there, and if possible, good sticker should be used for uniform coating, and seed should not store for longer periods, so it will minimize the efficiency of the biofertilizers, and it should not expose to the direct sunlight, should not apply along with the chemical fertilizer at any cost, and should have sufficient moisture in the field when we are applying the biofertilizers. These factors will influence the efficiency and quality of the biofertilizers and result of the biofertilizer also. And this is the application method. We can apply through spraying also in different crops. And application methods, we can mainly adapt to seed treatment and seedling dip and soil application. All these methods should follow with along with organic manure. Yeah, at least 200 kg FIM or vermicompost should be mixed with the 300 to 500 ml of liquid inoculants, and then this should be spread on the soil when the moisture is there. Immediately after microbial inoculation, if there is possibility of light irrigation, it will be always preferable. It can be used at the time of sowing, at the time after transplantation, 7 to 10 days after transplantation, or 7 to 10 days after, especially in chilies, we can apply after transplantation. And these are the azospirillum, around 10 to 12% along with we can increase the yields, and PSP 7 to 12% we can increase the yield, and VAM, with the VAM 6 to 10% yield will be increased. The mixed controls, what I am telling you, successful story of chilies in Guntur district particularly. This mixed biofertilizer, so azospirillum, PSP and KRB and mycorrhiza, it increases the yield by 13 to 23%. It is picking up very well in Andhra Pradesh, among the chili farmers. And the other part is biopesticides, which is the need of the day. We all know that chemical fertilizers, pesticides, disturbing the environment, ecological imbalance and soil factors, so many factors. And there is every scope to go for biopesticides, that it controls the insects, pests, micro. The biopests can be nematodes, microbes, biostimulants, to control pests and to control insects. Biopesticides mostly to improve the improves the plant health and quality. Extracts from plants are seaweed, natural compounds and plant extracts. Even pheromones can be called as biopesticides. Other naturally occurring biochemicals can be used. The plant incorporated protectants also, and that means GMOs can also come under biopesticides. Generally, if you take the difference between agrochemicals and agri-biologicals, cost effectiveness, the difference is there, and then persistence and the residual effect. It will be more with agrochemicals, whereas high with agrochemicals, it will be very low and mostly biodegradable and self-perpetuating in biopesticides. And knockdown effect also, it may be immediate in agrochemicals, it is delayed in biologicals. And pest resurgence also more in agrochemicals, it is very less in biopesticides. And resistance also, resistance will be more prone in agrochemicals, it is very less prone in biologicals. Beneficial effect on beneficial flora also, there is adverse effect on friendly pests destruction in agrochemicals, whereas less harmful on beneficial pests, and it is target oriented. So target is very specific in biologicals, whereas in agrochemicals it is mostly broad spectrum. Waiting time is also very high in agrochemicals, whereas almost nil in agri-biologicals. Nature of control is also, agrochemicals are curative, whereas in agri-biological it is preventive. So there is shelf life is more in agrochemicals, whereas shelf life is, which is a lacuna in agro-biological, it is very less shelf life. But in total, if you take it agri-biological advantages, we can promote agri-biologicals, and we can produce these biopesticides at farmers producer level or individual level or NGO level or at district level by department, by monitoring the Department of Agriculture and Agriculture Research. There is lot of scope commercially also for rural youth, biopesticides production, and production of biocontrol agents, a lot of scope in agriculture, because nowadays we had reached to that level that we are exporting the our produce. So there is every need to go for sustainable production, keeping the environment into consideration, and then quality of life into consideration, quality of the produce into consideration. So biopesticides are mainly derived from animals, plants and microorganisms such as bacteria and viruses. They are inherently less harmful than chemical pesticides, and they are more target specific than chemical pesticides, affecting only the target pests and their close relatives. In contrast to chemical pesticides, often destroy friendly insects, birds and mammals. They are often effective in small quantities also. They decompose quickly and do not leave problematic residues in the soil, and then produce also. And if you take important biopesticides and biocontrol agents, Bacillus thuringiensis, considered as the one of the best biopesticides, commonly used biopesticide globally. This has been used at globe level from 1975 or 76 onwards, and it is primarily a pathogen of Lepidopter and pests, which are some of the most damaging. When ingested by pest larvae, BT releases toxins which damage the midgut of pest, eventually killing it. By BT based pesticides are being marketed by three companies in India. The total sale in 1999 was about 70 tons. And this BT formulations almost occupies 70% of the biopesticides consumption in India, throughout the world also. These are the commercially available BT for different pests in different crops. And then one more biopesticide which has commercial value, and there is lot of scope for production of biopesticides, are Trichogamma. Trichogamma are minute wasps which are exclusively egg parasites. They lay eggs in the eggs of various Lepidoptera pests. After hatching, the Trichogamma larvae feed on and destroy the host plant, host egg. Trichogamma is particularly effective against Lepidopteran pests like the sugarcane internode borer, pink bollworm, and suited bollworms in cotton and stem borers in rice. They also used as against vegetable and fruit pests also. Trichogamma is the popular biocontrol agent in India. And if you take the other biopesticides, especially virus, that is baculovirus also, we can think of it. Almost 60% of 1200 known insect viruses belong to family baculoviridae. Baculovirus infection described in 700 species of invertebrates. Almost they are effective on Lepidopteran, Diptera, Coleoptera, so many. They are very effective on different species. This is the mode of action of the virus, and these are the commercial efficacy of baculoviruses against different insects, Helicoverpa, Spodoptera, Helicoverpa, Armigera, Anticapsia, Germinalis, Helicoverpa, Spodoptera. These are the larval. It is very easy for production as well as application. And mortality rate is also more than, it is very effective. More than 80 to 95% effectiveness is there with this application of these viruses. And the advantage of this field stability persistent is highly susceptible to damage by desiccation and by exposure to sunlight and UV radiations. Of crude sugar to Helicoverpa and NPV fluid increases persistence of virus both under natural sunlight and shade. Brightness reduces the gypsy of moth. Evening is preferable because of this, it is very selective for sunlight and UV radiations. Baculoviruses are always safe, only found in insects. హలో
దేక్ అసైన్ ద వర్క్ టు ఎవరికైనా అసైన్ చేసుకోమనండి, మనకు అవసరం లేదు, అదే డిస్కస్ చేద్దాము.
ఇట్ ఈస్ నారో హోస్ట్ రేంజ్ అండ్
హై సెలెక్ట్ రెడీగా ఉంటే తీసుకో,
నో ప్రొడక్షన్ ఆఫ్ మెటాబోలైట్స్ అండ్ టాక్సిన్స్, బ్యాక్లోవైట్స్ ఆర్ సేఫ్ అండ్ కాజ్ నో హజార్డ్స్ టు హ్యూమన్ హెల్త్. దీస్ ఆర్ ది ఫంగై మెటారైజమ్ వీ కెన్ అప్లై, బివేరియా బేసియానా వీ కెన్
సపోర్ట్.
నేను డిపార్ట్మెంట్ లో ఉండా. సాయంత్రం ఎన్నింటికి వస్తా?
హలో దిస్ మెటారైజమ్ అండ్ బివేరియా బేసియానా దీస్ ఆర్ ది మోస్ట్ పాపులర్ బయోపెస్టిసైడ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ఫంగై అండ్ దీస్ ఆర్ వెరీ ఎఫెక్టివ్ అగనెస్ట్ టర్మైట్స్, లోకస్ట్, and then sugarcane, spittle bug and grubs, and it is being also commercially produced by different organizations, and this can be
అరుణ్ అరుణ్ హలో ఓకేనా? హలో అరుణ్ 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 హలో
హలో హలో
సార్, సుబ్రహ్మ రెడ్డి గారు, యూ కెన్ కంటిన్యూ సార్.
ఓకే సార్, విత్ రిగార్డ్ టు దిస్ బివేరియా, ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ ఎఫెక్టివ్ అగెన్స్ట్ ఎల్కోవర్ప అండ్ స్పోడెప్ర ఆల్సో, బట్ దేర్ ఆర్ సమ్ లిమిటేషన్స్ విత్ దిస్ బివేరియా. దట్ మీన్స్ హై హ్యూమిడ్ కండిషన్స్ ఆర్ నీడెడ్ ఫర్ దిస్, అండ్ ఇట్ న్యాచురల్లీ ఆల్సో ఇన్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఏరియాస్ ఇట్ న్యాచురల్లీ ఇన్ఫెక్ట్స్ ది ఎల్కోవర్ప్ అండ్ స్పోడెప్ర ఇన్ సమ్ క్రాప్స్, ఎస్పెషల్లీ ఫోలేజ్ హై క్రాప్స్, ఎస్పెషల్లీ గ్రౌండ్ నట్ క్రాప్స్ లైక్ గ్రౌండ్ నట్. And then Paxillomyces, it is very effective against tea mites. And then Metarhizum is also very effective in rice bugs. These are the commercial biopesticides of Metarhizum available at at farmer level, produce with this entomopath pathogen is effective. This mode of action is adhesion to the spore to the host cuticle, spore germination, penetration into the through cuticle, growth on the cuticle, and death and saprophytic feeding, and then hyphal emergence and sporulation. This is the mode of action of this entomopathogenic fungi. There are so many botanicals are also there which are available which can be very effective against some insects and pets, especially chrysanthemum, ananascomus, tagetes erecta and hypoimia and Ricinus communis castor and then Allium sepa. These are also very highly botanicals, more than 2 lakh pesticides derived from plants are two ways, contact poison and stomach poison. About 250,000 plant species are evaluated at different levels, and then 2,121 are useful in pest management, 1,005 are exhibited insecticidal activity, 384 anti-feedants, 97 acts as repellents, and then 27 attractants, and 31 growth inhibiting properties. These are the plant derivatives, and these are also being commercially produced at different stages and by different organizations, and that are also being used by farmers, in especially in farmers who are practicing organic farming. And these are commercial botanical insecticides available in the market. And then with regard to this botanical pesticides, neem in India, neem is one of the best botanical pesticide, we can say, and it is almost effective against more than 250 species, insect pest species, and it will act as a both pesticide and fungicide as well as nutrient also. So there is every need to promote the neem also in the usage as a botanical pesticide. With regard to recently, this importance of biofungicides also increased a lot, and it is being experienced by the farmers who are interested in organic farming, and then alternative to bio chemicals. Especially if you take importance of plant diseases, if you take estimated annual crop production worldwide is 1.2-1.3 trillion, whereas amount lost due to diseases, insects, weeds using current control measures more than 500 billions. Additional losses without current control measures are 330 billions. And if you take current approaches to the disease control, it's mostly chemicals and breeding techniques. World spent around 43.4 billion on chemical pesticides, and if you consider it as it is less than 1% is actually gets in where the pathogen is, and what happens to the rest, if you think of it, it mostly it goes to the groundwater taken up by the plants and development of resistance, and most of the spraying chemicals are going waste. And then second part, we are throughout the world is going on this breeding techniques, identification of resistance genes, introgressing into commercial cultivars, and problems with the development of resistance pyrimidine genes. These are two factors. Biological control, we can say chemical pesticides are biological control agents. Generally, chemical pesticides implicated in environmental and human health problems require yearly treatments, and expense, it is becoming more expensive because it is off farm, because of this only it is costing more and toxic to both beneficial and pathogenic species. Whereas biological control agents, non-toxic to human and animal, it is non-polluted and host specific, only effective on one or two species. That is the basic advantage with biological control agents. Biological control agents are low cost, labor intensive, and host specific. Whereas chemical pesticides are cost effective, easy to apply, and broad spectrum. That's why most of the people are using chemicals in place of biological, but there is every scope and ample scope for promotion of these biological agents at a farmer level, at a NGO level, at a farmers producers organization, and even at the individual can also produce this, especially biological agent like Trichoderma. This is an excellent biofungicide, universally accepted by the farmers. Even farmers are using, most of the farmers who are progressive, they are using this and they are 100% satisfied with the effectiveness of Trichoderma. Very effective biological agent, free living and highly proliferating, non-pollutive, easy accessible, non-phytotoxic and systemic ephemeral, readily biodegradable, cost effective and the synergetic effect and the longer shelf life is there and the greater compatibility is there and it is universally accepted by the farmers. And if Trichoderma is a genus of fungi including many species that can be used to control a phytopathogenic fungi, generally soil dwelling saprophytes, they have a rapid growth rate, sporulate abundantly and compete with well with other disease causing agents and show resistance to chemical pesticides and produce various antibiotics like gliotaxin and viridin. And control of wood rotting, wood infecting and soil-borne fungal pathogens of seedlings and mature plants. And then there are so many species are there in Trichoderma which are being utilized in combination or singular form. These are being produced commercially and the government of Andhra Pradesh also, Department of Agriculture promoting this Trichoderma vitae production and usage, and the Department of Agriculture is producing at every district headquarter both the Trichoderma and the Pseudomonas and they are supplying to the farmers. It is being well accepted by the farmers. And the potential activities, biocontrol activities exhibited by Trichoderma are mainly antibiotic production is there, enzyme production is there, mycophora cytism is there, competition with other fungal disorders is there, growth effective, it is very useful for growth promoting nature is there, effective antagonist and rapid substrate colonization is also there. And if you apply Trichoderma once in a field, at least it will be very active up to 60 days after application. So up to 60 days it will protect the plant from other soil borne diseases. That is the most advantage of Trichoderma. And it is competitive for space and nutrients under specific condition, do not get subtract and suppresses growth of pathogen population very effectively. And then mycoparasite is also is there with Trichoderma, antagonistic fungi parasite, other pathogenic fungi, hypha of Trichoderma either grow along the host hypha or coil around it. So this is the mode of action and the interaction with the coiling of hypha around the pathogen, vacuolization process will be done by this Trichoderma, penetration by Haustoria and lysis. It penetrates, it coils around, penetrates and kills other fungi that are pathogenic to crops. It can digest their cell walls also. This is the mode of action of Trichoderma. And then antibiosis is also there. It is the condition in which one or more metabolites excreted by the organism have harmful effect on one or more other organisms. This is the production method of Trichoderma. And this can be, Trichoderma can be produced by any individual with simple equipment. Even with 1.5 to 2 lakh investment, even one rural youth can produce this Trichoderma at local level and they can supply to the fellow farmers at their block level. It is an excellent potential is there for production of Trichoderma. This is the mass production of biocontrol agents. These are the substrates, carrier agents used for Trichoderma. And this is the effective, we can see the difference of application of Trichoderma and then without application. We can see the difference, treated, untreated in a tomato, Trichoderma viridae. We can see the clear difference of controlling of diseases, damping off. and then this is in root rot in cotton. This is the Trichoderma vita versus for control of root rot in cowpea. So they, it is a very good effective and broad spectrum effect is also broad spectrum is there in with the Trichoderma. These are commercially available bio manufacturing is there and so many commercially it is available commercially with different brand names. And one more important and useful hello raapan ledha sir ppt షేర్ అవటం లేదంట పీపీటీ పవర్ పాయింట్ ఇదే షోర్ షేర్ అని
కాదు మీరు జూన్ లో లేనట్టున్నారు
ఉన్నానే
జూన్ లో కదండి జూన్ దాకా ఇది మామూలు మీకు తెలియదు
జూమ్ కాదు సార్ జూమ్ కాదు మనం ఇక్కడ హలో హలో రావటం లేదు సార్ హలో హలో ఇలా కూర్చుంది సార్
వచ్చిందా సార్? అవును. అప్లికేషన్ విండో. ఓకే ఓకే సరేండి. ఇప్పుడు వచ్చింది సార్, వచ్చింది. ఓకే, ఎక్కడి నుంచి రాలేదు సార్? ట్రైకోడర్మా వచ్చిందా? వస్తుందా సార్ ఇప్పుడు పవర్ పాయింట్? ఓకే, అయిపో వచ్చింది సార్. వినపడుతుందా సార్? హలో 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 వినపడుతుందా సార్? ఇప్పుడు తీయలేదు కదా అసలు, ఇప్పుడు దాకా వినపడిందిగా. ఇప్పుడు ఇప్పుడు వస్తుందా సార్? హలో, వాయిస్ రాకుండా. సౌండ్ ఇక్కడ వాయిస్ రావట్లేదు. ఇదే ఫుల్గా ఉంది రా. సార్ ఇప్పుడు వస్తుందా సార్? రావటం లేదా? ఇయర్ ఫోను కనెక్ట్ చేసిందండి. ఇప్పుడు దాకా వచ్చిందిగా వాయిస్. మైక్ లేకపోయినా వస్తాను చూడండి, మైక్ తీసేస్తాను. ఒకసారి పీకి మామూలుగా వస్తుంది అంటారు. వస్తుందా సార్? ఇప్పుడు దాకా వాయిస్ వచ్చింది కదా సార్. స్పీడ్ హలో, ఫైనల్ టచ్లోకి వచ్చాం, ఇప్పుడు అయిపోయింది. ఒక్క నిమిషం ట్రై చేస్తాను సార్, ఒక్క నిమిషం. హలో, ఒకసారి సౌండ్ రావట్లేదమ్మా వాయిస్. హలో,
అరుణ్, అరుణ్, అరుణ్,
మధ్యలో పవర్ పాయింట్ రాదని రాలేదని పవర్ పాయింట్ షేర్ అవ్వటం లేదని చేశాము. పవర్ పాయింట్ షేర్ అవుతుంది, ఇప్పుడు మైక్ రావటం. హలో, మనకు కూడా వినపడుతుంది. శంకర్ గారు, పెట్టాను, ఇప్పుడు దాకా వచ్చింది మళ్ళీ మైక్ యాక్సెస్. చూస్తాం ఒకసారి చెప్తా.
హలో వస్తుందా సార్? ఓకే ఇస్తాను సార్. చూడండి పీపీటీ వస్తుంది. వచ్చింది చూడండి. రైట్ రైట్ సార్, థ్యాంక్ యూ. వన్ మోర్ మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ బయోఫంగిసైడ్ ఈజ్ సూడోమోనస్ ఫ్లోరోసెంట్ అండ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఆల్సో ఏ కామన్ గ్రామ్ నెగటివ్ రాట్ షేప్డ్ బ్యాక్టీరియం అండ్ బిలాంగ్స్ టు సూడోమోనస్ జీనస్. సూడోఫ్లోరోసెన్స్ హ్యాస్ మల్టిపుల్ ఫ్లాజెల్లా. ఇట్ హ్యాస్ అన్ ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్లీ వర్సటైల్ మెటబాలిజం అండ్ కెన్ ఫౌండ్ ఇన్ ది సాయిల్ అండ్ ఇన్ వాటర్. ఇట్ ఈస్ అన్ ఆబ్లిగేట్ ఏరోబ్, బట్ సర్టన్ స్ట్రెయిన్స్ ఆర్ కేపబుల్ ఆఫ్ యూజింగ్ నైట్రేట్ ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ ఆక్సిజన్ యాజ్ ఏ ఫైనల్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ యాక్సెప్టర్ డ్యూరింగ్ సెల్యులార్ రెస్పిరేషన్. అండ్ సూడోమోనస్ ఫ్లోరోసెన్స్ ఇట్ యాక్ట్ యాజ్ ఏ ప్లాంట్ గ్రోత్ ప్రమోటింగ్ రైజోబాక్టీరియా ఆల్సో. ది ఇంపార్టెంట్ గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ బ్యాక్టీరియా దట్ ప్లే మేజర్ రోల్ ఇన్ ది ప్లాంట్ గ్రోత్ ప్రమోషన్, ఇండ్యూజ్డ్ సిస్టమిక్ రెసిస్టెన్స్ అండ్ బయలాజికల్ కంట్రోల్ ఆఫ్ ప్లాంట్ ప్రొజెన్స్ ఎక్సెట్రా. అండ్ సూడోమోనస్ ఫ్లోరోసెన్స్ యాజ్ బయో కంట్రోల్ ఏజెంట్ గ్రో ర్యాపిడ్లీ ఇన్ ఇన్వైట్రో అండ్ టు బి మాస్ ప్రొడ్యూస్డ్ ర్యాపిడ్లీ యూటిలైజ్ సీడ్ అండ్ రూట్ ఎక్స్వేట్ అండ్ కలనైజ్ అండ్ మల్టిప్లై ఇన్ ది రైజోస్పియర్ అండ్ thermosphere environments and in the interior of the plants. This mode of action of Pseudomonas fluorescens is antibiotic production, siderophores production, induced systemic resistance, competition, hydrogen cyanide production, plant growth promotion, antibiotic production. And competition is this establishment of other rhizos. This Pseudomonas fluorescens preempt the establishment of other rhizosphere microorganisms through competition for favored sites of the roots and in the rhizosphere. And hydrogen cyanide production is representative of class of volatile inhibitors. The Pseudomonas fluorescens produces hydrogen cyanide production which can check growth of phytopathogens. It is very effective. And then plant growth promoting and antibiotic production also observed in and it produces hormones, phytohormones like auxins, gibberellins, and also by phosphate solubilizing nature is also there in Pseudomonas fluorescens. And these are the trade names and commercially available at different sources Pseudomonas fluorescens, and it is widely accepted by the farmers, and the Department of Agriculture, Government of Andhra Pradesh is also producing the Pseudomonas fluorescens and supplying to the farmers at reasonable prices. And pathogens controlled by Pseudomonas fluorescens are Pythium species, Rhizoctonia solani, Erwinia gattuea, Telaviopsis basiocola, and Graminis variety. Mode of application is application methods of Trichoderma pseudomonas. We can apply as a seed treatment at the rate of 10 kg, 10 grams per kg seed, and it can applied as a soil application, 90 kgs FOM club and 10 kgs neem cake and 2 kgs of Trichoderma or Pseudomonas mixed with the FOM, and it can be applied to the soil. And foliar nutrition also, 5 grams or 5 ml per liter, we can foliar spray. This is especially biofungicides had been commercially available in large quantity because of the involvement of the Government Department of Agriculture and the Department of Horticulture. It is being produced at the government level. That's why the usage of these both Trichoderma and Pseudomonas is very much more and among the farming community. Whereas with regard to biopesticides, there is no channel in the for production of biopesticides, especially BT or Bavaria or Metarhizum. These are not being produced by the government agencies. If the government produces these biopesticides at departmental level or agriculture university level, the promotion of the biopesticides also will be more at farmer level. And these biopesticides and biofungicides and to some extent biofertilizers can be produced and marketed by individual farmer or farmers producer organization or NGO or at the department level or agriculture university level. There is lot of scope for these biofertilizers and biopesticides. I will complete my lecture. Hello.
Hello.
Sir.
Hello.
Arun. Okay. Hello. Shankar. Hello. Good evening, everybody. Okay, 5 minutes. Hello. Good evening, everybody.
Hello.
Sir, is it okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Good evening, respected our Adjust Srikanth Garu, MD and CEO. I'm sorry to join in the inaugural function. And respected Subram Reddy Garu. And this is the most important and it's a most economical and can be implemented very easily by the farmers as well as the entrepreneurs. As I have some interaction with Subram Reddy Garu, when I approached him, he suggested an easy methods to value add to the fertilizers that we are wasting a lot in our daily life, or the farmers also not properly preparing the value added fertilizer, this manures, especially for goat and buffalo dungs. So we thought that the farmers as well as the entrepreneurs can start their small startups entrepreneurship with making the biofertilizers. And these biofertilizers may be very useful for organic farming as well as to reduce the crop, to reduce the production prices especially. So at the same time, as we are using the fertilizers, the land, especially the land is going to be is a tank for the residues which not properly used by the particularly plants. And as this goes on, we and the next generation people will eat only the residues of these fertilizers. So this is the ultimate point. At this point, every farmer and every citizen of India has to see that we have to use the natural fertilizers, especially the manures, which can be naturally made. So with this small idea, we thought that we must do something in this biofertilizers. As in this, we have the two aims. We want to increase the employability in this sector, as well as the APSSDC and the Honorable Chief Minister wants to wants to promote the entrepreneurs, especially in the agriculture sector. As this is the allied agriculture sector part, our due to in keeping in view of the vision of our Chief Minister, Honorable Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy garu, we want to do something in this area. So, especially in this regard, we requested our Subram Reddy garu to take the initiate. I request the Subram Reddy garu to take the initiate and to do something to promote the entrepreneurs as well as the farmers to make the natural fertilizers, natural manures, especially when we look into the, our normal markets, as I am the farmer community and the shepherds as well as the farmers and this the small animal growing has been reduced and the animal farms are coming with the smaller size 10 to 15 animals and they are producing the dung in a large quantities, especially for 1 or 2 tons per a day. Especially sir, this is we are asking you take the responsibility, Subram Reddy garu taking the responsibility to make or to prepare a small entrepreneur model which can make 2 to 3 tons per a day, especially organic manure. So to increase the carbon content in the manure, we request you sir to take the lead and to promote the entrepreneurship as per the wish of our visionary CM and the visionary CEO of our APSSDC, Ajay Srinath garu. I hope we will do our level, we will do the best in near future and we come up with a model. With that model, we will take up offline training and for a size of 50 people. And after that, if it is a successful model, then we will go to each and every district. Thank you with these small words. I request we are putting the total responsibility on Subram Reddy garu to promote this, to carry out this activity to a realistic stage. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. We can make it successful, sir, as per your wishes. And we can definitely create employment for rural youth at village level.
Yes.
And then there is always eminent scope is there for this value addition, sir, as you told. So we can, for example, we can incorporate this other programs with this linkages with this program, sir. For example, as a small example, if we give any under any program one animal to one family, if we train them for production of azolla and vermicompost and then establishment of gobar gas plant, he can produce around 8 tons per annum, sir, vermicompost. On average, he will get around 30,000 to 40,000 rupees income from that vermicompost, which is higher than milk yield, sir. And
yes,
we can value that with biofertilizers, sir. So definitely there is ample scope, sir. We can prepare a model as per your wishes, and we can go ahead with this program, sir.
Sir, this is the wish of our visionary CM, sir. So,
sir?
As we all know that today, the manure gobar gas utilization in villages, in my childhood, we have a gobar plant in my house, sir. But
yes, sir,
because of this, then ready-made, as when we interacted with you, suggested compost by culture making and vermicompost, these are value addition to the. And especially for the unemployed youth, when they want to move to the cities, they expect the higher salaries, sir. But with, as you said, that if they can earn 1 to 1.5 lakh per annum at their native villages, it's a more valuation, sir. this will be happened only through the agriculture and agriculture byproduct and animal husbandry department only, sir. So we request you to develop a model which we can make the entrepreneurs capable of earning 1 to 1.5 lakh per annum. Thank you very much, sir. Personally, we will meet you, sir. And please prepare a model, sir. Then we will have the offline sessions, offline training program, so that we can take up a model of 50 entrepreneurs, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much, sir, for giving me this opportunity to interact with enlightened people like Dr. R.J. Srikanth gar and Dr. D.V. Ramkota Reddy garu and other participants. Definitely, we will go for the benefit of farmers, sir, in future, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much.
Hello. Sir.
We can close the session.
Okay, sir.
Or anybody, if the participants wants to speak, ask them any participant to speak.
Okay. Participants, meeku emaina doubts emaina unte ganaka hand raise ana option untundi. Adu ok sari raise chesi manaki ikkada request pettandi. సార్ ఒక రిక్వెస్ట్ అనేది వచ్చింది సార్ సిరాజ్ అనే దగ్గర నుంచి
రిక్వెస్ట్
సార్ సుబ్రహ్మ రెడ్డి గారు మీ మైక్ కూడా ఆన్ చేసి పీపీటీ క్లోజ్ చేయండి సార్ మనం అతనికి మైక్ ఇద్దాం ఓకే సిరాజ్ గారు మీరు మాట్లాడండి సార్
గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్
సార్ గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్ మాట్లాడండి సార్ మీ డౌట్ ఏంటో
Sir, we want to know what is the process of acquiring manufacturing and marketing license for organic fertilizers.
Hello.
Sir.
Hello. Sir, inipadutunda
sir? Inipadutundi
sir. Mana organic fertilizers manufacturing and marketing ki separate license evana kavala sir maniki?
అంటే మన వర్మీ కంపోస్ట్ కి వాటికైతే అక్కర్లేదు సార్
ఓకే ఓకే
ట్రై ఇప్పుడు ట్రైకోడర్మా సూడోమోనస్ అయితే మనం రిజిస్టర్ చేయించుకోవాలి సార్
ఓకే సార్ ఓకే
అట్లానే బయో ఫర్టిలైజర్స్ కూడా మనం రిజిస్టర్ చేయించుకోవాలి
అంటే ఎక్కడ చేయించాలి సార్ ఇది రిజిస్ట్రేషన్
మన ఫర్టిలైజర్స్ మన జాయింట్ డైరెక్టర్ ఆఫ్ అగ్రికల్చర్ గుండె డిస్ట్రిక్ట్ లెవెల్లోనే వీ కెన్ రిజిస్టర్ ఫర్ బయో ఫర్టిలైజర్స్ నో ప్రాబ్లం
ఓకే సార్ దీనికి ఏమైనా ఎలిజిబిలిటీ ఏమైనా ఉండిద్దా సార్ లైక్
అంటే ఇక్కడ చిన్న పాయింట్ సార్ ఈ బయో ఫర్టిలైజర్స్ అంటే అనేసరికి ఏమవుతుందంటే దీనికి ఏమో ప్రొడక్షన్ కాస్ట్ చాలా తక్కువ సో విపరీతమైన మార్కెట్ ఇమీడియట్ గానే ఉండదు
అదే సార్ అవును
అందుకని మనం ఇన్ కాంబినేషన్ వర్మీ కంపోస్ట్ ఎలాంగ్ విత్ బయో ఫర్టిలైజర్స్ ఎలాంగ్ విత్ ట్రైకోడర్మా విరిడి అంటే మనం ఒక ఒక 5 lakhs తోటి ఒక యూనిట్ ఎస్టాబ్లిష్ చేయొచ్చు సార్ సింపుల్ వేలో
ఓకే సార్ ఓకే ఓకే
5 lakhs తోటి అయితే మనం మినిమం ఇందాక సార్ అన్నట్టు సంవత్సరానికి 5 lakhs ప్రయాణం ఈజీగా సంపాదించవచ్చు ఈజీగా సంపాదించవచ్చు రెండో పాయింట్ ఏంటంటే మనం సమాజానికి ఎంతో కొంత ఉపయోగపడతా సంపాదించవచ్చు అదొకటి మంచి పాయింట్ రైతులకు ఉపయోగపడతా
సార్ అట్లాగే మనకి ఇప్పుడు ట్రైనింగ్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ అన్నారు కదా సార్
సార్
ఇది ఎట్లా సార్ ఇది అంటే ఆల్రెడీ రన్నింగ్ లేకపోతే స్కెడ్యూల్ ఏమైనా ఉందా చేస్తున్నారు అనుకుంటున్నా
ఇంకా అది ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఫిక్స్ కాలేదు సార్ ట్రైనింగ్ సార్ వాళ్ళు ఒక దీన్ని అంటే ఇప్పుడు కరోనా దీని వల్ల ఇదవ్వలేదు
ఓకే అయితే మనకి ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఎట్లా తెలుసు సార్ అంటే ఎప్పుడు అన్నది ఎవరిని కన్సల్ట్ చేయాలి మనం ఈ ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఒకవేళ షెడ్యూల్ చేస్తే ఎట్లా
అట్లానే సార్ ఈ ఏపీఎస్ఎస్ డిసిఎల్ మన అగ్రికల్చర్ యూనివర్సిటీ కాంబినేషన్ మాట్లాడుకొని ఒక షెడ్యూల్ తయారు చేసి ఇట్ విల్ కమ్ టు యూ సార్ డెఫినెట్లీ
Okay, okay. So they will update us, right? Okay, okay.
Definitely.
You must start it.
Okay, sir. Fine. Then this is what I want to know. Thank you, sir.
Okay, Mr. Welcome, sir.
Yeah.
Any participants, you can raise your hand and ask your doubts. సార్ మనకి క్వశ్చన్స్ ఏం రావట్లేదు, సెషన్ క్లోజ్ చేద్దాం సార్.
ఓకే సార్.
సార్ ఒక్కసారి స్టూడెంట్ ఒక క్వశ్చన్ అడిగారు సార్, అది మీకు ఫార్వర్డ్ చేస్తాను.
చెప్పండి సార్, పంపించండి సార్.
సార్ మీకు రైట్ సైడ్ లోని చాట్ బాక్స్ ఉంది చూడండి సార్, చాట్. ఆ చాట్ బాక్స్ లో ఇప్పుడు ఆ క్వశ్చన్ పేస్ట్ చేస్తున్నాను సార్.
మీరు వచ్చి వాళ్ళు
సార్ ఒకటి ఏంటంటే, ఈ ఎజోస్పెర్మ్ క్యారియర్ తోటి అని అన్నారు కదా, సీ ట్రీట్మెంట్ గా వాడుకోవచ్చు మనం. క్యారియింగ్ అంటే ఏం లేదు సార్, పైన ఎఫ్ఐఎం తోటి మిక్స్ చేసుకొని వాడుకోవచ్చు. హలో
సార్, సార్ చెప్పండి సార్.
హలో, మనము సీ ట్రీట్మెంట్ గా వాడుకోవచ్చు, తర్వాత సీడ్లింగ్ ట్రీట్మెంట్ వాడుకోవచ్చు, తర్వాత మూడోది పెంట పోగు మట్టి ఎఫ్ఐఎం తో కలిపి కూడా మనం సాయిల్ అప్లికేషన్ చేసుకోవచ్చు సార్.
ఓకే ఓకే సార్, అదే క్వశ్చన్ అడిగారు సార్ వాళ్ళు ఫస్ట్ స్టార్టింగ్ లోని.
మూడు రకాలుగా వాడుకోవచ్చు సార్, ఇబ్బంది లేదు. కాకపోతే కెమికల్ ఫర్టిలైజర్స్ తోటో, కెమికల్ ఈ గులికల తోటో కలిపి వాడకూడదు
సార్. మనకి ఎనదర్ ఉంది సార్, ఇంకో క్వశ్చన్ పెడుతున్నాను.
పెట్టండి సార్. Along with vermicompost, perlite and vermiculite also good. Vermiculite కూడా మనం వాడుకోవచ్చు సార్. vermiculite అయితే ఇంకొద్దిగా కాస్ట్లీ అయిపోద్ది మనకి, అదర్వైజ్ దట్ కెన్ ఆల్సో బి యూజ్డ్.
ఇంకోటి కూడా
బీటెక్ కి ఉపయోగపడుద్దా అని ఒక అబ్బాయి పెట్టాడు సార్. బీటెక్ లో, బీటెక్ కాదు ఏదైనా కానీ, ఎనీ వన్ కెన్ ప్రొడ్యూస్ బయో ఫర్టిలైజర్ సార్. దట్ ఈస్ మీనింగ్, అంటే సెల్ఫ్ గా ఏదన్నా చేద్దాం అనుకుంటే మాత్రం ఇట్ విల్ బి యూస్ఫుల్ ఈవెన్ వితౌట్ ఎనీ క్వాలిఫికేషన్ ఆల్సో వీ కెన్ ప్రొడ్యూస్ దిస్. ఎస్పెషల్లీ వర్మీ కంపోస్ట్ అయితే అసలు ఏం అక్కర్లేదు, జస్ట్ ఒక 3 డేస్ ట్రైనింగ్ చాలు, ప్రాక్టికల్ ట్రైనింగ్. బయో ఫర్టిలైజర్స్ సబ్జెక్ట్ మీద మన వీ కెన్ గివ్ ట్రైనింగ్ ఆల్సో సార్.
ఓకే సార్,
ఒక బ్యాచ్ ఉంటే ఎట్ ఏఆర్ఎస్ అమరావతి వీ కెన్ ప్రొవైడ్ ట్రైనింగ్ ఆల్సో, నో ప్రాబ్లం.
అతనే మళ్ళీ ఇంకోటి పెట్టాడు సార్ ఒకసారి చూడండి.
అదే, ఐ హావ్ ఇంట్రెస్టెడ్ ఆన్ బయో ఫర్టిలైజర్ సబ్జెక్ట్ సార్ అని పెట్టాడు.
అదే సార్,
బయో ఫర్టిలైజర్స్ మనం ఆయనకి గోపికి ఏ అనుమానం ఉన్నా హీ కెన్ ప్రొసీడ్ అస్ సార్. నా నంబర్ ఇవ్వండి, ఐ కెన్ టాక్ టు హిమ్, నో ప్రాబ్లం
సార్. అలాగే సార్, అలాగే సార్. ఓకే సార్, ఇంకా స్టూడెంట్స్ కి ఏమైనా చెప్పదలుచుకుంటే చెప్తాను, సెషన్ క్లోజ్ చేద్దాం.
అంటే ఒక్కటే సార్ నేను చెప్పేది, అదే మనం నేచర్ ని కాపాడుకుంటూ వెళ్లాల్సిన అవసరం ఉంది. తర్వాత ఫార్మర్స్ ఇన్కమ్ ని పెంచే అవకాశం ఈ బయో ఫర్టిలైజర్స్ బయో పెస్టిసైడ్ ద్వారా ఉంది సార్. కనీసం చిల్లీ ఫార్మర్ కి ఒక 5,000 ఖర్చు తగ్గిస్తుంది సార్ ఎకరానికి ఈ బయో ఫర్టిలైజర్స్ వాడితే. 5,000 అంటే ఒక్కింట ఎక్స్ట్రా పండించినట్టే. దాన్ని మనము డిఫరెంట్ మోడ్స్ లో రైతులను ఎడ్యుకేట్ చేసుకుంటూ వెళ్తే మనకి కొద్దిగా సాటిస్ఫాక్షన్ ఉంటుంది, రైతులు కొద్దిగా ఇబ్బందులు పడకుండా బయటకు వస్తారు అనేది నా ఒపీనియన్ సార్. తర్వాత రెండోది ఏంటంటే మనం నేచర్ ని కాపాడుకుంటూ ఉండాల్సిన ఉండే దాంట్లో ఇది ఒక పార్ట్. 25% కెమికల్ ఫర్టిలైజర్స్ యూసేజ్ తగ్గించుకుంటూ వస్తే మన ఇంపోర్ట్స్ మీద పడే బర్డెన్ చాలా తగ్గిపోద్ది. కాస్ట్ ఎఫెక్టివ్, పైగా ఎకరానికి 100 రూపాయల నుంచి 400 అవుద్ది ఇది. దాని మీద మనం కాన్సన్ట్రేట్ చేస్తే మంచి ఉపయోగం ఉంటుంది సార్. సెల్ఫ్ ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్ కింద కూడా దీన్ని స్టార్ట్ చేయొచ్చు.
సార్ ఇంకో క్వశ్చన్ ఉంది సార్.
సార్
చూడండి సార్ ఒకసారి క్వశ్చన్.
అంటే ట్రైకోడర్మా కొంతవరకు హార్మోనల్ ఎఫెక్ట్ ఉంటుంది అండి, ఏది సాయిల్ ఫర్టిలిటీ మీద. కాకపోతే ఈ కాంటికి యూజ్ అయితే బయో ఫర్టిలైజర్ ఎంతో కొంత ఫైటో హార్మోన్స్ రిలీజ్ చేస్తుంది ట్రైకోడర్మా, గ్రోత్ మీద ఇంపాక్ట్ ఉంటుంది. బట్ వి కాంట్ కాల్ ఇట్ యాజ్ ఎ బయో ఫర్టిలైజర్.
ఓకే సార్. ఓకే సార్ సెషన్ క్లోజ్ చేద్దాం.
ఇంకేదన్నా డౌట్స్ ఉంటే నా నంబర్ ఇవ్వండి శంకర్ గారు.
అలాగే సార్, అలాగే సార్.
వాళ్ళు ఎప్పుడు కాల్ చేసినా ఐ విల్ క్లారిఫై దెమ్.
ఓకే సార్. ఓకే సార్.
మీ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్కి చాలా థ్యాంక్స్ సార్, ఎందుకంటే ఇన్ని ఇబ్బందులు ఉన్నా సమ్హౌ వి కుడ్ ఏబుల్ టు. థ్యాంక్స్ టు రెడ్డి గారు అండ్ శ్రీకాంత్ సార్ అండ్ శంకర్ గారు.
ఓకే సార్, థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్. థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్. థ్యాంక్స్ సార్. మీరు ఎడ్యుకేషన్ అని చెప్పారు, క్లిక్ చేయండి సార్ అక్కడ పైన.
సార్
ఎండ్ సెషన్ అని చెప్పేసి ఉంది కదా సార్ పైన.
ఓకే సార్.
థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్ సుబ్రహ్మణ్యం రెడ్డి గారు.
థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ రెడ్డి గారు. థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ సార్.
ఓకే సార్, థ్యాంక్ యూ. యు ఆర్ మోస్ట్ వెల్కమ్ సార్. We will do good things in near future, sir. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Hello. Hello.
End it. Yeah, recording. Recording.
పార్టిసిపెంట్స్, మీరు మీకు ఇచ్చిన ఫీడ్బ్యాక్ ఫామ్ లింక్ ఉంది కదా, లింక్ లోని మీరు ఫిల్ చేసి పంపించి సబ్మిట్ చేయండి. అది అప్డేట్ చేసాం, అది లింక్ అదండి. Thank you.